I'm Dr. C Ramachandra, Director, Kidwai Memorial Institute of Oncology, Bangalore. Ours is a regional cancer center. In fact, a lot of people ask me this question. See, what I used to practice about 25 years back when I joined this profession, we used to see about 6 or 7,000 patients in a year. Today, it's reached about 20,000 cases in a year. And right now, we see about 3.5 lakh follow-up cases in addition to this 20,000 new cases. There are two issues I would like to address. Number one, there was a time where people never used to diagnose properly. In the rural areas, there was no consultant to diagnose. Many people used to die without diagnosis. So the number looks small. And the second issue is even the incidence of cancer has gone up now. There are many reasons. It may be, you know, environment, it may be genetics, or it may be, you know, consumption of food, diet, so many things. But the incidence also has gone up, as well as the diagnosis and awareness of the people also has gone up. So this, the burden has increased comparatively, you know, they going back to 10 or 20 years. See, what we used to see about 16 or 18 per lakh in about 20, 25 years back, today Bangalore is seeing 32 or 34 per lakh of women. So this has gone drastically increased. So for that matter, lung cancer, it used to be very low. And today we see a lot of lung cancers, and 70% of lung cancers because of smoking, whether it is chewable or smokable tobacco. Oral cavity cancers, what we used to see 20 years back, today is doubled. So everywhere, you know, you go back to see that the cancer burden is definitely increased. See, it has evolved over a period of time. This institute has opened in 1973 with a small, you know, chemotherapy and palliative ward. And later on in 1980, it became autonomous. One visionary called Krishna Bhargava was the director. He has taken it forward. And what we used to see that time, to get a linear accelerator, so, you know, the Vice President of President of India, or even the Health Minister of Center, used to come and inaugurate, because it's a luxury. Probably it is the second, you know, linear accelerator in the South India. Today, or what we see the number of patients and the treatment is definitely evolved in a big way. Today we are no less than anybody in the world. And the kind of machinery what we have about 8 linear accelerators, and we have about 3 cobot machines today. And we treat on an average about 60 to 80 patients, or even go up to 100 patients on each machine. It means to say that I can treat up to 800 to 1000 cases every day. That's a very big number. So our walk-in patients are approximately 1200 to 1500 today. What we used to say 300, 400 or 200 patients, and we started about few, you know, head counts. But now it has evolved over a period of, you know, 25 years to a very big hospital today. And we used to struggle to, you know, get suture material in the past. Today we have a robotic surgery worth about 16.5 crores, and it costs about 3 to 8 lakhs outside, but we are doing free of cost here. And the kind of radiation machines we met with IGRT, 4 machines we have. And, you know, those days, even to get a cobalt machine in the past, it was so difficult. You could have seen, you know, one cobalt therapy, whole face used to get dark for about 6 months to 1 year. Today, you don't even see a mark after the completion of the treatment. In addition, the 3D laparoscopy and the technology in radiation, the technology in the medical oncology, we never had a bone marrow transplant. We had a 2-bed transplant. And today we are, you know, by the end of April next year, we are going to open one of the biggest bone marrow transplant units. And we never had a CT scan in the past. Today we are getting not only CT scans, we are going to get, we'll have 3 CT scans and 2 MRIs, and in addition we are going to get a PET scan by the next year beginning. So it has evolved over a period of time. The technology has changed, the treatment has changed, and even it's simplified also. And comparatively, we are no less than anybody in the world. The biggest challenge is, you know, money. Cancer treatment is very expensive outside. Probably people have to sell their houses. And it's not one-day treatment. It's not like fever or, you know, appendectomy, hernia, where you remove and get away, get out of the hospital, you're done. Not like that. You need to have surgery, radiotherapy, chemotherapy, hormone therapy, target therapy, so many therapies, including immunotherapy. Like if you go to outside, see, like what I told about robotic surgery, it costs 3 to 8 lakhs. Today we are doing free. And 90% of the patient what we get here is below poverty line. About 10% or maybe 12% of patients are affordable. Even for them, it's a very subsidized rate. For example, a breast cancer surgery costs them about 18,000 rupees here. Whereas outside to go, probably the cost of surgery costs about 1 to 1.5 lakhs. And the same way, the chemotherapy drugs we give at a very subsidized rate. Nearly 30-40% of subsidized rates we are giving, and we are going to have Amrit Pharmacy. We are going to further subsidize more. And the most important landmark here is the government has subsidized, and government has included a scheme called, earlier it used to be called as Vajpayee Arogya Scheme. Now, Arogya Karnataka and Ayushman Bharat are clubbed. So these two together, 90% of the patients get free treatment here. It means to say all that they have to show is they are below poverty line, show a BPL card and their treatment up to 5 lakhs is free. Imagine this, this cannot be possible anywhere in the world. This is the biggest boon I can say to the poor people. Yeah, it's a very good question. You know, in fact, the central government is keen to implement already across the country. Karnataka has accepted. But the main problem is I'm not able to treat many Ayushman Bharat patients because the government has not streamlined what on what basis you're going to treat. Like, should we treat on Aadhaar card? Should we treat on Ayushman Bharat card? Or should we treat on income certificate? So that has not been streamlined. So majority of the patient who come from outside, still we are paying from our patient welfare fund. Hardly we have registered few cases from Ayushman Bharat who have a genuine BPL card or a genuine, you know, Ayushman Bharat card. The government should make a decision based on this, either the Aadhaar card or issue Ayushman Bharat card to all BPL patients across the country. If anyone shows that he is a BPL card holder in anywhere in the country, we should be able to treat. It's easy, but that's not streamlined. That's why we are not able to enroll more patients into Ayushman Bharat. Across, you know, we are spending so much of papers. My biggest future plan is to make this institute paperless. And already the process is on. We are halfway down. Probably by March, we are going to become paperless. Probably in the entire country, this is going to become the first government hospital to become paperless, number one. The advantage is, you know, even on a website, patient can take appointment and come. An illiterate patient who doesn't know about a website can walk into the doctor. Doctor can open in the computer and check. He, through the PACS, he can get all the investigations, X-ray, CT, MRI, everything in the computer. And the job is made easy. They need not wait in the queues for getting the file or collecting the reports. All these things will become streamlined. And the other thing is, I want to acquire in future a proton therapy. We lack proton therapy. It's very expensive. I want to approach the state and central government. It costs approximately, you know, 300 to 400 crores. And, you know, Tata Memorial is getting, I'm aiming for that. And next thing is to see that to simplify the treatment, make the patient waiting period to reduce completely.